Hello there, this is Jennifer McGuire. Today's video has a technique that is one of my favorites. I've done it before and I know lots of other people have, but I thought it'd be fun to visit it again. And this is spotlight die cutting. So basically you take a stamped image and you kind of spotlight or kind of pop up some shapes from that stamped image in different colors, just to give some fun dimension. This is a great way to stretch your stamps. If you head over to my blog after watching this, I'll have links to some other cards like this that some of my friends have done that I think you'll find inspiring. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. I am using this Simon Says Stamp Stitched Squares die set. The great thing about this die is it has the cutting line in the center and then faux stitched lines on both sides of the cutting line. So after I die cut this, I get the faux stitching on both the negative space and the positive space. I'm just using the positive space today, so I'll save the negative space for another time. And I'm going to go ahead and cut three of these squares. I plan to make two cards and then we'll need a spare. So let's go ahead and stamp our sentiment. This is from the Simon Says Stamp April 2015 card kit. Now, you can buy the stamp set separately if you'd like to also. I have a stamping pad here. Since this is a pretty solid sentiment, I like to put a stamping pad underneath there. You could use a mouse pad too, or you could just do it right on your table and you should be fine. And I'm stamping that right in the center of all three pieces with my favorite black ink, which is Hero Art's black dye ink. Now we're going to use two of these to make a card, and that third one is a spare that's going to help us with this technique. So let's go ahead and do our little spotlight pieces, these candles. Now you could easily die cut any shapes you want to for this technique, but I thought candles would be fun, and I don't have any candle dies, and so I'm just going to make my own. So I just have some cardstock scraps here, just in a few different colors, and I'm cutting them, they're about 1¾ inches tall and a little over 1/4 inch wide. Really doesn't matter how big they are, it's totally up to you. This is a great way to use up some of your scraps. You could even use pattern papers, but I recommend using a pattern paper that's tone on tone because you don't want to distract from the stamping that we're about to put on this. So I'm creating a bunch of candles here so I can make several cards at once. Again, at the end of this video, I'm going to show you how to do this with die cutting or another way to go about doing this technique, so be sure to stick around for that. So now that I have all my candles cut here, I am going to go ahead and do the stamping on them. So this piece here, the white sentiment stamped piece in the background, that is our spare, so our third spare one. And I'm temporarily adhering the candles right on top of it where I want them to be. So there's just some temporary adhesive on the back of that. I just use my stamp runner to do this. Now once I have the candles exactly where I want it, I'm going to stamp on top of the candles and I'm going to look through my stamp, since it's a clear stamp, I can easily see through it, to stamp right on top of where the stamping is on the white. Now you could use a stamp positioner or the Misty stamping tool to make sure you stamp exactly on top, but I found it really doesn't have to be perfect. So if you stamp slightly off, it's okay. So I'm taking that same stamp with the same black ink, and I'm going to look right through the stamp and stamp right on top of the sentiment that's already there. Now remember, the white piece in the background is our spare piece. So if I don't exactly stamp lined up, it's okay. Nobody will ever know, and your candles will still look good. So now I'm going to go ahead and remove my little candles. And now I'm going to add that onto one of my final stamped pieces here. Remember, I have these two that are final here. And I'm going to put some foam tape on the back of my candles and adhere right on top of that white stamped piece, lined up perfectly. Now for foam tape for these tiny little candles, I'm just taking a long strip of foam tape. I love this stuff. And I'm cutting it down the center so that I can make it nice and thin so it'll fit behind these candles. Now I really think using foam tape here is great because by popping it up, it really creates that fun 3D effect. So I'm going to remove the release paper here, and you'll see that I'm going to line this up right with the stamping in the background there. And you can just look down, and now it's got this fun dimension, and it kind of spotlights that candle. Now I'm going to do the exact same thing with the other two candles. I'm going to put some foam tape on the back and line it up with our stamped image. So think about it. You could take this sentiment stamp. You could spotlight with maybe a balloon, a heart, a star, anything that you want here. This is a great way to get more out of your stamps and your die cuts. But in this case, I didn't actually even use a die to do this. I just created the candles myself. And here you can see how that dimension really adds to the spotlight technique. Okay, so I needed some flames to go on the top of my candles. I couldn't figure out what to use to create my own flames, so I actually used raindrop die cuts. So this is from a Simon Says Stamp die that's an umbrella with some raindrops. And I die cut some drops from orange and yellow cardstock. However, unfortunately, the biggest drop was a little too small to act as a flame for my candle. I probably could have used it, but I wanted it to be bigger. So I'm going to kind of create my own based on these little raindrops. So I am taking the largest of the raindrop die cuts and gluing it on to some yellow cardstock. Once I have those glued there, I'm going to go ahead and cut around it to make a larger flame out of the yellow with that orange kind of towards the center bottom of it. The nice thing is that no two flames are really alike and they're never quite perfect. So it really doesn't matter how well this turns out. I just want to get the effect of a flame. I guess I could have used a heart and maybe cut the heart in half for the flame, but this worked out just fine. So now I need to add these little flames with some foam tape. Now, getting pieces of foam tape behind these little flames can be tricky, but my trick for any kind of small pieces, I find usually if I cut my little pieces of foam tape into small triangles, it usually fits behind the piece okay. Like under these flames, it works perfect, or on the back of a tiny little heart. Usually a small little triangle of foam tape works perfect. So you may have noticed that in this stamped image, there is kind of some sketchiness to kind of make it look a little rough, which is fantastic, but I really wanted a graphic looking card. So I decided to go in with black ink and fill it in so that the sentiment is solid. I kind of like stamps like this that give you the option. You can leave it with that kind of sketchy look, or you can fill it in with a black pen to make it solid. So I just wanted to go for the more graphic look here. I also decided that I wanted to feed my addiction a little bit and add some Wink of Stella shimmer to this. I put a lot of the Wink of Stella on the flames because I really wanted that to sparkle. Then I also took the Wink of Stella to the candles, but I didn't go over the black ink. I kind of went around the black ink. I could have gone over all of it, but then I'd have to color in the black sentiment in the background. So I just decided to try to keep the Wink of Stella shimmer just on the candle and flames itself. And I actually went back and did a second coat so that they were really shimmery. I thought that since this card was pretty clean and simple, to add a little bit extra shimmer would be fun. I was planning to be a little crazy and leave the wicks off the candles, but it was bugging me. So I decided to go in with a Zig silver glitter pen and just draw the wicks in. This would have been easier to leave off or have done this before I glued the flames down, but you know, I just felt like I needed to add it. Now, the one last thing I wanted to do to this stamped piece is add some glossy accents to the flames. And I went overboard. I completely went overboard. I'll admit, I went overboard. I'm taking the glossy accents and I'm going to put one coat down on top of each of the flames. And then I went and I took my daughter to school and then I brought her back. After this all dried, I put on another coat onto the flames so that there was a ton of dimension on these flames and also that Wink of Stella's shimmer behind it. And it really made a big difference to have that much dimension and shine on these flames. I just think it was really fun and it's something I encourage you to try sometime. And of course, I have that nozzle tip added to my glossy accents bottle, which makes it really easy to add just the right amount of glossy accents on those tiny little areas. Now for the background of my cards, I have this craft cardstock with foiling on it. This is in that same Simon Says Stamp card kit that the stamp set's in. I've cut my card down to 4.25 by 4.25, and I glued that piece to cover the entire front. Now I wanted to add my square stamped piece onto the front of this card with some dimension. I like to use pieces of fun foam or craft foam for large pieces that I want to pop up instead of the little pieces of foam tape. So I'm putting some adhesive on my card and I'm putting some adhesive onto the craft fun foam. Usually I put the adhesive on the back of the stamped piece that we want to adhere here, but that's wet right now with the glossy accents. So basically all I'm doing is sandwiching that piece of fun foam between our stamp square and the background of the card. And that pops it up and will keep it nice when we send this through the mail. I really like having that cardstock with the foil already on it. It really saves me a lot of time from not having to do any kind of technique on the background there. Now I did do a second card, same thing. I used the same technique, and this is another piece of the cardstock that's included in that card kit. I just think it's beautiful. Now before we wrap up, I wanted to show you one more way of doing this spotlight die cutting technique, and this time I actually use a die cut. So I'm going to show you this really quick. I have a piece of cardstock that I did some tone-on-tone stamping with. I'm going to stamp this large sentiment with black ink. This sentiment is also from that same Simon Says Stamp stamp set. I'm just going to stamp that on there, and then I have a balloon die. This is also from Simon Says Stamp. I'm going to position it right perfectly center in the center of this sentiment. So once I have it exactly where I want it, I'm going to use a piece of tape to hold it in place so we can run it through our die cut machine. So I'm just going to run this through my die cut machine, and then I have my spotlight balloon perfectly centered on the sentiment. So now I have also a white square that has the same sentiment on it, and I can just glue this one on top with some foam tape, and we have that same technique of spotlight die cutting. And again, there are many ways to do this technique, but I really think that this and the technique I showed you earlier really are the quickest and easiest way to do this. So there you can see how I spotlighted with the balloon instead of the candles like I did earlier. You can do this with pretty much any basic die shape you may have. So that's the video for today. If you're interested in the products I use, they're linked below in my YouTube description, or you can head over to my blog at jennifermcguireinc.com, where I'll have much more information. Thanks so much for stopping by, and I hope you'll come back soon.